What up, Deuce Gang? I'm my guy. You already know this guy over here. Together, we are two guys doing a podcast. We bring you the latest, the greatest, and sometimes a little bit disgusting news. You know, the latest of the day. I just want to know, man, before we get into this, if y'all like the content, please drop a like right now. Just do it right now before we get into this content, man. And also subscribe to us because we're going to bring you this every day. But I got a question for you. I got a question for this guy. Can I ask you a question?
No, but yes.
What's going on today?
Why are we still talking about Cat Williams and Kevin Hart?
Is it us talking about Cat Williams or is it Cat Williams talking about Cat Williams? Cat Williams is talking about Cat Williams.
Well, when I say we, I'm speaking generally. So why does the public still... Haven't they been beefing since forever?
Let's be real. Let's be real. Before Kevin Hart was Kevin Hart, there was Cat Williams. If Cat Williams didn't get into all the crazy shit that he got into, who knows what Cat Williams would have been at this point? Like, the man was in Boondocks.
That doesn't make your career, okay? Hey,
to me, that's a huge. Wait a second. Hold on a sec. Yeah, because R. Kelly was also. Well, it wasn't really him though. Okay.
You need a higher bar. Let's cut to the tape, please.
Ask you, if you would be bothered enough, because I know you're normally very unbothered, to do a versus battle between you and Kevin Hart. A lot of fans want you to do it for the culture, do a comedy battle. Would you be bothered enough to do this?
I started versus.
Come
to me with versus. The first versus ever promoted was Steve Harvey versus Cat Williams. It was the underground king of comedy versus. And sold as versus. So we don't need to ask me if I would have any interest in things that I am the originator.
Okay, Cat on his Soulja Boy tip.
Beefing is my lane. It's almost cheating for me. I have over 10 specials, so I don't have to pick but two jokes from each special, and I've already deaded anybody whose last name ain't Prior anyway. But having thrown that out the window, we don't want to add 52 movies. We certainly don't want to add 11 specials. We certainly don't.
Cat turned to a tiger.
We don't want to add 49 television appearances. We don't want to add an Emmy. It's almost a battle we can't really afford to be in because he's on his 16th 100 city tour. So it probably don't match up the way you think it match up.
I mean, at this point, you said what you said and you meant it.
Yeah, so I'm saying I wouldn't involve.
The originator of the verses, that's obviously false because we all know that came from SoundClash. But as far as two titans, there is content out there that you guys could listen to. It's actually really, really funny where Cat Williams is speaking to Steve Harvey. And when I say it's funny, I mean it's funny as hell. He goes in on Steve like, you don't want this smoke. But so he has that point. But a verses versus Kevin Hart. And Cat Williams, I've seen Kevin Hart live. He's really funny, but Cat Williams would completely rip him apart.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you very much. Listen, this is no disrespect to Kevin Hart because Kevin Hart is a very, very talented comedian. I've seen his specials. They're hilarious. But anybody who knows Cat Williams comedy or has watched any of his Pimp Chronicles series, this man will have, it's every joke. It's every line. Sometimes he doesn't even say anything. Sometimes it's just the tone of his voice, which you could say as a Kevin Hart fan, all the same things about Kevin Hart. Very true. But, you know, when it comes to Cat Williams, the thing that I feel separates him from the fact that separates him from Kevin Hart is just his delivery is so natural. When I watch Kevin Hart perform his stand-up comedy, it looks very rehearsed. It looks very perfect, which is great. I mean, naturally. I guess that's what he's trying to achieve, right? That perfection level. But when you can just naturally deliver your comedy and make it feel organic, make it feel real, like it's just me and you and we're just telling a story, man, to me, that's what the Eddie Murphys had. That's what the Richard Pryors had. the ability to just tell a story and make you feel like, you know what I mean? We're just chilling, hanging out, and it's just fun. This doesn't feel like it's so perfect.
Look, everything you said, I'm on board. But here's the reality. There's two types of comedians. Ones that can perform. That's Kevin Hart. He's great on screen. He knows what he's doing. And he brings that on-screen persona to the stage. But there's also another type of comedian. Ones that are absolute masters of what they call playing the dozens. And the dozens is literally just looking at a stranger. They've never met them in their entire life. But how they look, what they're wearing, they can use that and just rip them to shreds, insult right. the shit out of them. But not anyone could just do that. Ah, your sweater is black. No, they can make it really, really funny. And that's what Cat Williams is amazing at. He knows how to play the dozens. That's not Kevin Hart. He funny.
Definitely not.
Funny, but he can't play the dozens. So that's it just... Apart from everything Kat was saying about the accolades, and you could say that matters or not, whatever, you know, but just the simple fact that you put them two in the ring, one of them just really knows how to throw a punch and the other one doesn't. That's kind of it, you know.
All that being said, though, I would still love to see it. I would absolutely want to see it. I personally don't think Kevin Hart would ever agree to it. I feel like Cat Williams could get to a point where he would agree to it. If there ever comes another controversy between him and Kevin Hart, Cat Williams is absolutely going to try to suggest
Listen, I actually like Kevin Hart. I'm a Kevin Hart fan, so I do not want to see Kevin Hart completely humiliate himself on tape. So if I was in Kevin
Hart...
Not about spice, it's just about knowing your limits. If I was spicy in thing. Kevin Hart's camp, I would say ignore this. Or you don't have to ignore, you can entertain, but do not sign up for anything. This would be bad for you. You know, because it's documented now. Talk about a blemish on your record. This is not the smoke you want. So that's what I would be saying. Hey, I could be wrong, viewing public. Well, we could be wrong. What are your thoughts? Leave it in the comments. Do you think Kevin Hart's got the smoke for Cat Williams? Nah. Leave it in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Look.
Yo, thanks for watching that video, making it all the way to the end. You made it this far. You have to like. Please subscribe and comment on the video as well. Join the conversation.
Absolutely. We finally hit our goal of 500 subscribers. Yes, we are trying to get to 1,000. And we can only do that with your help. You can start by watching that next video. You see that tiny little icon? Click on that icon, rinse and repeat. Deuces.
Deuce.